What's up, guys? We know why you're here. You're looking for three amazing tips to become an amazing photographer, and we're going to tell you how to do that super easy, super fast, and after this video, you're going to be able to go out and you're going to shoot a wedding with any gear, be it a fancy camera or something with a kit lens, a basic. You know what? We're going to talk about basic. If you have a basic kit camera, you can shoot a wedding and you can shoot amazing photos, and we're going to go through and tell you how to do it. Easy peasy. Beautiful. Let's go. Let's get those photos. Let's get you to be an amazing wedding photographer. Woo! All right, so first of all, what we're gonna talk about is posing. People have a lot of problems posing their bride and groom, and it's, you know what? I have a problem with this lots myself. Luckily, my wife and I shoot together, so we have two photographers. If I'm having issues, she's actually really good with posing. She takes over. But if you don't have someone to lean on, this is the perfect tip to get you through the whole session, keep things rolling, keep it going, and get those awesome shots. So what we're talking about is not actually posing. We're gonna get the bride and groom to stand back and we're gonna tell them to do an action. The first thing that I always like to do is tell them to just hold hands and then just walk away nice and slowly. And when we say, turn around, come back, walk towards the camera. It's a nice warm-up exercise that gets them used to being shot without having to look at the camera, without smiling at the camera, nice, comfortable, and easy. And you can get them walking hand in hand, just like it will be when they're coming back up the aisle after they kiss and they say I do's. And it gives you all the time in the world to get them to relax, relax yourself, and you can get these framed photos with them walking nice and beautiful. Now you're gonna continue this practice throughout the session. All you have to do is get them to do an action. This photo right here, for example, nice simple photo of the bride and groom. All we told her was you're gonna grab your groom's tie and you're gonna pull him in nice and close. Now, you're not allowed to kiss until we say so. So she's pulling him closer, 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 and it's creating that tension between them, and it's creating an atmosphere, it's creating emotion, and it gives you time to snap a nice shot where it's not a forced pose where you're wondering, okay, maybe their finger isn't in the right spot, maybe they need to be leaning like this, and you're kind of manipulating them and they're ending up feeling like a marionette puppet or something. It leaves you for a much more natural scenario with much more natural look where they're comfortable, you're comfortable, and you can snap a great photo. Now, I'm not saying don't pose. If you can think of a pose, if you have a pose in mind, if something works, fantastic, go for it, fly. We do it all the time. But this is certainly a fallback, and it works your clients into the photo groove, and it works you into the photo groove as well. And it's an easy, awesome way to get amazing shots super easy. Now, second tip, we're gonna be talking about isolating your subjects. You can get amazing photos when you're doing something like this, boom. You get a lot of background, you get all these epic arch with the old wood in a barn, it looks so fantastic. But if you look at this photo, your eye isn't really drawn to the bride and groom. Your eye is drawn to the architecture, the light coming through, the colors, the contrast. Now that's a good thing, it makes for good photos, but when it comes to a wedding, you really wanna try and create an atmosphere around the bride and groom. Create an emotion, make them feel close to each other, make the person who's looking at the image feel nice and close, and feel the love kind of thing, if you get what I'm saying. So here we have a bride and groom along a nice fence line, and you have this grass coming in over top of the lens. It kind of blurs it out, gets that nice kind of depth of field. Now, I took a blade of grass and all I had to do was hold it in front of my camera lens and focus on them, and it gives you that nice framing around the bride and groom. It's a really nice and easy way to actually create depth and create emotion within the image and make you feel much closer to the bride and groom that you're shooting. Now, another way is to actually get a nice low depth of field with your lens. 50mm lenses are a great way to achieve this. You can get a nice low depth of field, usually like an f1.2, f1.4, something like that. Get that background looking real blurry and really create an intimate feel and make you really draw into your subjects. Now, the third point I've got for you is probably the most important of all of these, because you can still get amazing shots without the two topics that I just talked about, but you will most definitely benefit from this one the most. Have fun. And I'm not just saying you have to have fun for yourself because you're not gonna enjoy shooting otherwise. I'm also talking about have fun with your subjects, with your clients. Make them feel comfortable. Joke with them, be entertaining. The more comfortable they are with you, the better the photos will be in the long run because they're relaxed, they feel comfortable, they're understanding that being shot by this camera in their face is okay, they can make jokes about it, and it works out to your benefit. A lot of the times you can end up with some goofy photos like this one, for example. This bride and groom wanted a karate shot. So they were thinking like the Karate Kid. So boom, we got the shot, nice silhouette against the sky. Pretty awesome. Now, it's not an amazing photo, but it's an amazing photo for them because they can look back and they like this entertainment aspect. Or there's another one here where we were shooting with the bride and groom at this bar on the resort they were at. Great, amazing photo. They're having fun with it. Another one, let me see what else we got. We've got this one. Butt grab. Simple butt grab. Clients are comfortable in front of you. They'll do some goofy things, and goofy things make for great memories. If a client can walk away with A, great photos, and B, great memories, then you've done yourself an amazing job as an amazing wedding photographer. So guys, take these three steps, take these three tips, go out and shoot a wedding, and I guarantee if you combine them all, you will end up with some amazing shots, and you will be booking yourself more and more photo shoots in the long run. Guys, thank you for watching, and I hope you guys can put these three secret tips to your benefit and go get some awesome photos. I'd love to see some photos, so hit me up on the link. I want to see what you guys shoot. Don't forget to like and subscribe. If you guys have any other topics you want to talk about or any other tips you'd like to share, I'd love to hear them. So guys, thanks. I will see you later.